Next question. You're supposed to factorize the following algebraic expression. So you have 4x plus 1 here, 4x plus 1. So you let a equals to 4x plus 1. You don't choose x equals to 4x plus 1, and it's just confusing. So you just give another alphabet to represent this whole thing. So you are taking this one and this one as if it's one term. You're replacing the whole thing with a. So when you replace that whole thing with a, it looks something like a square minus 2a minus 15, right? So that looks, at least it looks doable compared to the first one. So when you have this and you need to factorize, then ask yourself, can I, there's three ways to factorize: take out common factor, use special products, or use cross method. And this is a quadratic expression, so obviously we need to use cross method. So we have a square negative 15 and you have minus 2a. Times a, 15 is 5 and 3. This is a negative, so it must be minus. So this like that, like that. This is 3a. Add them together, so you get minus 2a. So then you copy this down. So you get a minus 5. A plus 3, right? But the thing is, this is not all. The thing is, you have substituted this whole thing with a, so you need to replace back. So this a is actually what? 4x plus 1. So and then this looks, you now need to put back the 4x plus 1 into this thing. So you get 4x plus 1. A is 4x plus 1, right? So then after that is minus 5. This one. This is a plus 3, but my a is actually 4x plus 1. So it will look like that. So when I simplify this, it looks like this. 4x minus 4. And then this one is 4x plus 4. Right? Okay, so now that's done. So this one, can you factorize some more? Actually, yeah, you can. So if you were to take out common factors here, it is actually 4 bracket x minus 1. Take out this common factor here. So this will give you this. This one, I realize that there's some common factor. I take out 4 again. I take out 4 again, so you get x plus 1. So this is 4 times 4 is 16. This is, it gives you 16, x minus 1, and x plus 1.